Knock, knock, knock. Can I come in?
Hi, I'm Dr. Gibi. Do you remember me? I've been seeing you since you were really, really, really little, so it's so good to see you again. I'm so glad that you came in for your yearly checkup. That's so healthy of you. Yes, so every year we get to check different things about your body. We get to check how you're growing, or if there are any problems that I can help you with, or fix, or do anything about. Now is the perfect time to ask, but if you have any questions during your checkup or after your checkup, you can always call, or, you know, one of your family members can call for you, and we can get that sorted out, okay? You don't have to wait for your yearly checkup all the time. Okay, so let's get started. Alright, so can you tell me your name? First, middle, and last. Very good. And your birthday. Do you know how old you are? Awesome. Okay, so you stood on the scale earlier, so we have your weight. And then we're gonna get your height and see how much you grew. Alright. So I have this little slidey guy, and what I want you to do is stand right under this part here. Perfect. Okay, got it. Let's see. You are in a really good percentile for your height and weight. Do you eat a lot of vegetables, fruit? What's your favorite food? Awesome. Do you drink a lot of water? How much water? You drink it with every meal? And do you drink water when you're playing sports or playing outside? Good. That's awesome. Okay, so I'm gonna put this over here. And next we're going to get your temperature. So I'm going to use one of these. It reads your temperature just by pointing this at your forehead. So you don't have to put anything under your tongue or anything like that. So you can just look straight ahead. Perfect. I got it. Thank you so much. So you're feeling pretty healthy today. Don't feel like you don't feel any sort of cold or headache or tummy ache or anything like that. That's good. Perfect. Okay. Where did my pen go? There it is. Next, I'm going to listen to your heart. I'm going to use my stethoscope here. That's this thing around my neck. You know what a stethoscope is? So I put these in my ears. And I'm going to put this on your chest. Okay, now I can hear your heart. So I'm going to ask you to just breathe in for me. And breathe out. Very good. Can you do that again? Breathe in. And breathe out. Perfect. One more time here. Breathe in. And breathe out. Okay, now I'm going to put it on your back, and we're going to listen to your lungs too while we do this. Can you breathe in? And out. Okay, and for this one, breathe in. And breathe out. Okay, you can breathe normally again. That all sounds really, really good. The next thing I'm going to get is your blood pressure. And that just means I'm going to put this cuff around your arm. It's going to get nice and tight around there, and then all of it will go whoosh. And that's it. Okay, so give me this arm here. Let's do this one. Okay, do you feel like that's on? Good, good, good. So if that's on, Then I'm just going to squeeze this little thing here. Do you feel it getting tighter? Yes, that means it's working. All right. And whoosh. All done. Awesome. Blood pressure looks great. And then I'm going to want to take a look inside your ears. Do you have any hearing problems? Do you ever have problems hearing what your teacher's saying? Or if any family members are calling your name from another room? Sometimes you don't hear them. That's okay. That's normal. Okay. I'm going to put this just a little bit inside your ear. It might tickle a little bit. Yeah, it tickles. Okay. It looks pretty clean in there. That's really good. Good, perfect. And then let's check your other ear. You have two of them. Okay. Good. Awesome. Looks really, really great in there. We're going to use a new little cap here to look into your nose and mouth. Let's do your mouth first. So go ahead, open your mouth for me. Great. And you haven't had your tonsils out or anything like that, do you? No strep throat history? Okay, good. And can you say, ah? Good. I'm just going to put this on your tongue and press down. Can you say, ah, again? Ah. Great. And then can you show me your teeth like this? Can you bite? Good. And I'm just going to feel your jaw. Like this. Go ahead and open your mouth. Wiggle it side to side, and you can close your mouth. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Do you brush your teeth twice a day? How about flossing? You can always try to do better with flossing, don't worry. You are not the only one. Okay, then we're gonna take a look in your nose. Go ahead and look up. Great, perfect. Okay. For your eyes, we're going to do a little eye test. And if there's anything that I think you might need to go see the eye doctor for, I can send you to that too. The resident eye doctor is very nice. You would love her. Okay. So I'm going to have you look straight ahead behind me. And I'm going to shine a light near your eye. Your other eye. Very good. Now, can I have you look at the tip of my finger here? The one that's glowing. Yeah, that one. Now, if you would, can you just follow my finger with your eyes? Don't move your head. Awesome. Mm-hmm. Ooh, I was moving a little fast, but that was good. Perfect. Very good. Now I want you to go ahead and look at my nose. Can you look at my nose? Oh, good job. You're looking at my nose. Okay. Now keep looking at my nose. I'm going to hold a few fingers up and you're going to tell me how many fingers. But I want you to look at my nose. Look at my nose. Okay. Ready? 2 fingers. Very good. Keep looking at my nose. 3 fingers. Awesome. 1 finger, very good. 2 fingers, awesome, okay. Very, very good. That was fantastic. And what you can see behind me, I'm actually going to ask you to do. So can you cover your left eye for me, just with your hand? Perfect. Okay, back here. I'm just going to ask you to tell me what the shapes are that I'm pointing at, okay? Okay, great. Good. Wow, awesome. Okay, you can take your hand off of your left eye and go ahead and cover your right eye. Good job. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing. Whatever I point at, you tell me the shape. You did such a good job the first time. Ready to do it again? Okay. That was great. You're so excited. Do you participate a lot in school and class? Yeah? That's really good. Okay. Now for your hearing, your ears looked very clean, very great. You've understood all the questions I've asked you so far. So, the tiny little hearing test we're going to do for you, we're going to put on these headphones. Do you like Pokemon? Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely. So, when I put these headphones onto your ears, it's going to be hard to hear me, but you're going to hear some sounds. And when you hear the sound, if you hear it in your left ear, I want you to raise your left hand. And if you hear it on your right ear, I want you to raise your right hand. So whatever side you hear the sound on, you can raise your hand, and when the sound goes away, you can put your hand down. Sound good? Okay. Here we go. Okay, ready? I'm gonna start. That's it. Awesome job. Yeah, that's a fun one. And then I'm going to lean into each ear and whisper a word, and I want you to tell me what I said, okay? Okay, here comes the first word. Another word.
Rhinoceros. Wheat bread.
And then last one.
Swing set.
100%. So when you're in the car, do you wear your seatbelt all the time? Good. And when you're crossing the street, do you look both ways? When you meet someone that you don't know, do you know, have you talked about strangers and what to do if an adult you don't know tries to talk to you? Yeah, we want to try to find an adult that we do know. And your family will always tell you if someone is going to come and pick you up from school or something like that before that happens, okay? Okay, awesome.
And what if a stranger were to come and ask you to help them find their lost puppy? You would go get an adult that you do know. Awesome job. Okay, do you have pets at home? Good. And do you have siblings? Can you tell me some of your friends' names? Are they in your class? And what's your teacher's name? Do you like your teacher? Okay. All right, that sounds good. Okay. So I'm just going to have you lay back against this bed that you're on, and I'm going to just be going like this against your tummy and down your body, and I'm just feeling the insides where, you know, your stomach is and all of your other organs. So if anything hurts, please tell me, okay? So it should not hurt, but if it does, let me know so I can help, okay? Here we go. Any of that hurt? Nope, all feels perfect. All feels great. I'm just going to examine your arms. Can you raise your arm for me? Good. And your other arm. Does that hurt? No? Good, good, good. And your legs. I'm just going to have you pull your leg up so we can see your knees. Great. And your other leg. Do you like to play outside? What's your favorite game? I always loved Red Rover, but then it got too dangerous, so we weren't really allowed to play that anymore. I'm not gonna tell you the rules, no. Okay, so do you know what this is for? We're gonna test your reflexes. So I'm gonna give you a little tap, tap, tap on your knee, and it's going to just pop up like that. So what I need you to do is just totally relax your knee. Ready? Relax, 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 relax. Oh, see? That's your reflexes. Let's test your other knee. Perfect. Okay. We also have them in our elbows too. So go ahead and relax your arm. Perfect. And your other arm. Right. Can you put your hands like this for me? Now flip them. Flip them back. Flip them back. Okay. Can you press them together really tight? And can you go like this with your fingers? Very good. Okay, you can just shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Now I want you to just grab my finger and squeeze it really tight. Good. And do it with the other hand. Squeeze it really tight. Okay, great. Now I'm going to put my hands up like this, and I want you to put your hands on mine and give me a little push. Good. Now I'm going to give you a little push, and I want you to hold yourself up. Ready? Awesome. So strong. Okay. So if you stand up here, just on this little stool here, there you go. I have you touch your toes. Very good. And touch your toes again. I'm just gonna look at your spine. See if it's curling in straight. Very good. Okay. And then can you stand on one foot? Look at my nose. Awesome. Okay, switch legs, stand on the other foot. Look at my nose. Very good. Okay, now while you're still standing, I want you to look at my nose. Put your hands all the way out and bring your arms in and touch your nose. Can you do that? Ready? Go. Very good, very good. All right, you can sit back down. The next thing I want to do is the lice check, as you guys are going back to school. We're going to try to catch the lice outbreaks before they start. Have you ever had lice before? Oh, it is just so annoying. So we love to do that. Make sure nobody's bringing lice into the school. Okay. So I have a little stick, and I'm just going to use this to comb through your hair and take a little look at your scalp. Ready? Do you brush your hair every day? Someone takes care of your hair? That's good. Looks really clean, which sometimes is tough because lice love clean hair, but don't worry, because just because you have clean hair doesn't mean you're going to get lice. It's nice to have clean hair. Just remember not to share hats with your friends or hair brushes or anything like that. Always bring your own. Okay. Good. And then the very last thing is your booster shots. I think we only have one today. It's a little one. So if you want to just do it now, that sounds good. You're so brave. We actually have, I don't know if you remember, Booster Bunny. You remember Booster Bunny? Well, Booster Bunny loves to sit with brave kids who are getting their boosters. So you can have Booster Bunny right there. Booster Bunny actually loves a little squeeze. Loves a little squeeze, so you can do that there. I'm going to put this on your arm first, which is just a little alcohol pad. You're probably going to be able to smell that. You smell that? Yeah! This is just making your arm nice and clean. Great. And you can look by me. Do you want to look at that chart? Or you can look at Booster Bunny. But I'm just going to count to three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Done. That was amazing. And you get to pick a Band-Aid. What are you thinking? Well, we have plenty of Mickey Band-Aids. There's Donald as well. How about this one? This one here. Can you see it? That's a good one. Okay. And you can keep this Band-Aid on for a little bit. Don't have to keep it on for a while. Too long. There you go. So good. Alright, so did you have any questions at all for me? Okay, well, if you think of any of them, you can always have someone call and ask them later. Sometimes, I don't know, we don't remember their questions before we leave. Yeah. Well, if you would like a lollipop, we have a whole basket of them out in the waiting room on your way out. And I will see you next year. You did really well. It was so good to see you. And I hope you have a great rest of your school year. Bye-bye.